Aipac is the oldest pro-Israel lobby in the U.S. Originally called the American Zionist Committee for Public Affairs, Aipac was founded in 1951 by Isaiah Keenan, who was a registered Israeli foreign agent. Their main goal was to secure weapons and financial assistance to the newly formed State of Israel. The name was later changed so that it can be registered in the U.S. as a tax-exempt social welfare group, which allowed Aipac not to disclose information about the sources of their funding. Aipac is part of a large pro-Israel network in the U.S. Today, Aipac is part of a much wider network of pro-Israel lobby groups working to achieve bipartisan U.S. support for the State of Israel by making contributions to Israel-friendly lawmakers. Millions generated by Aipac annually. By its own admission, Aipac has 100,000 members. Through various different donations and club membership fees that range from $60 to $100,000 a year, Aipac generates millions. According to the group's most recent public tax records, they received more than $96 million in 2017. Pro-Israel groups engage in political fundraising. Officially, it is illegal for Aipac to engage in political fundraising, but that's just a technicality. Fundraising is a huge part of the group's operation. In the 2018 midterm elections, more than $14.9 million was raised by pro-Israel groups for candidates. That's their third biggest contribution ever. Out of 435 members of the House of Representatives, 269 received pro-Israel lobby contributions at an average of more than $23,000 per representative. And out of 100 U.S. senators, 58 accepted contributions at an average of more than $77,000 per senator. Aipac pushes for laws in Congress. Each year, Aipac and other pro-Israel lobby groups put their weight behind a number of legislations, especially when they are anti-Iran, anti-Palestine, and of course, pro-Israel. These legislations include moving the U.S. Embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, cutting aid to Palestinians, and countering the BDS movement. The group also lobbied heavily against the Obama-era Iran deal, which President Donald Trump withdrew from in 2018.